Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynet and welcome back to our XCOM 2 Commander playthrough. We're right in front of another retaliation mission, aptly named Death Father, with a very difficult difficulty rating. So that promises to be a hell of a mission. So we're gonna bring out our best troops. We're gonna have Humongous, our healer, then Benito Buffon, our amazing specialist hacker. Then we have Christoph Vinewood, our ranger, our superb ranger. Then we have Ulrich Edel, our best grenadier in the bunch. Geralt of Rivia, another of our grenadiers. And then Terrilia, Cedric, Play, our amazing sharpshooter. So with that, we should be able to handle anything that comes at us. So let's launch this mission. So yeah, retaliation. We need to rescue as many civilians as we can. Without, of course, losing any of our soldiers in the process.
One of our contacts in the Resistance says Advent peacekeepers have been spotted conducting a sweep near an outpost in this area. The aliens won't hesitate to kill anyone they find, so we're heading in to protect as many people as we can. Secure the camp and eliminate all hostile forces.
Looks like we're gonna have a large building in the center of the map, which is gonna be good if we can quickly clear that out and use that as a higher ground for Cedric. Because that would be very nice, because then we have a kind of a vantage spot for him and we can clear out the rest of the map starting from there. But that's all depending on where we start, of course. If we don't start near that building, we're gonna have a bit of a problem. There we go. So we're not going to start in concealment as always in retaliation missions. Aside from Christoph, who's going to start in concealment either way.
Menace 1-5, hostile forces are attacking the outpost. Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians.
So concealment for Christoph, and then
came in hot and so did we. You won't have a concealed position for deployment on this one.
So just quickly looking around, we can see two civilians already. So if we can get to those two, that's a nice start. I'd have no idea where that building is. Might actually be in the back here somewhere, because I'm not really seeing it, which is too bad. But yeah, without further ado, let's put everybody a bit closer. Can I get a bit closer than that? Apparently not. Can't get to the side of the car, sadly. Although I might be able to with the grappling hook. Ooh, that is actually a nice position. So let's put Cedric right up there. He gets a shot if he sees anything. Yeah, okay. Oh, shit.
They can't do much from range, but they're lethal up close.
Oh, that is a problem. Berserkers. And two mutants. So that civilian is running away from us, which is bad. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to start this off with a grenade. Do have to be careful not to hit that civilian though. Shit, this is hard to get at the start already. Let's see. Is this? Yeah, that's full cover. And we could get a few nice shots in from there. So let's get Vrij a bit closer. There we go. Let's put Geralt closer as well, so he can get a grenade in as well. There we go. What the plan is, I'm gonna try and take out the armor of the Muton. The closest mutant, because I think if I just hit it like that, the truck is going to still explode. So I'm not going to even try that. I'm just going to try and take out these two. That should be fine, I think. So plasma grenades are now 4 to 5 damage. And they shred a bit more armor, if I'm not mistaken. So let's try it with that first. Here we go. Geralt, nice first shot. Oosh! Don't think the truck got hit. Looks like it's still fine, and the Muton lost all its armor, which is fine by me. Next up, Vrij, I think we have a better shot with your gas grenade. and that should be able to kill everybody. Well, not kill everybody, but hit everybody. So there we go, I think. So that's not hitting the truck. Yeah, okay. Not that I think that a gas grenade will blow up a truck, but yeah. Don't want to risk it anyway. Because if we blow up the truck, we kill the civilian with it as well. There we go. And we shredded a bit of armor as well. That's good. And it doesn't look like the truck is going to explode anytime soon. And that berserker is freaking out a bit. I think he got his ability off there. Not that I can see really clearly. If you're wondering why the camera is shaking so much, that's because of the berserker. So those guys only have melee attacks. But they can move up really quickly if they want to. So, Hugh, let's put you over... You need to be careful. I'm gonna put you over there. Hopefully not triggering anything else, because that would be bad. We could get a shot at the Berserker, but I think I'm gonna go for the Muton. Could start shooting at the Berserker, though. Although the sniper... Cedric has a really nice shot at him as well. Although I am going to try... Let's first try this. Lightning hands at the Muton behind the truck there. Because he's annoying over there. So that was a hit. Didn't trigger the truck. So that's good. Hit the blade indeed, but that's not bad. And then 6 to 8 damage is of course really nicely if we can get that off on the... on the Berserker, and I think I'm gonna have to see what I can do with Christoph as well, cause... Okay, what? What?
The Resistance managed to recover and restore a handful of these mobile communications jammers over the years. With a few makeshift repairs, these things have proven invaluable to the Resistance effort.
Okay then, that's good for them, I suppose. So now we have a flank shot on the Muton, which is not actually that good. And we get another shot at the other Muton as well, but it's even worse at that. So let's boost Benito a bit further and see what we can do. If we're able to... Ooh, we're able to hit pretty much everything, but the Muton behind the truck, of course, has a really low percentage chance. We now do a guaranteed 4 damage with the plasma grenade, so the Muton in the middle is dead nonetheless, but... I don't want to waste too many grenades right now if we can help it. So if we shoot 79 on the Muton for some reason. And that is weird. Let's see. If I'm able to hit the Muton behind the truck, 64. If I'm able to kill him, because that was a problem I had with that from above. If I'm able to kill him, then I should be fine, I think. Because I think that from above only triggers on enemies that I can kill. So height advantage, and he's poisoned as well, so that should diminish his aim. Yeah, here we go. Ah, god damn it. Okay, that was painful. Is that? That truck isn't on fire, is it? No, okay, so the fire is next to it. Okay. Damn it, Cedric, why did you miss that one? Hugh. Why is that closer Muton so much better off on aim percentages, that is. What's my chance at the Muton here? 79. So I'm gonna try that first. So Benito, take out the Muton. Yeah, there he goes. That is something at least. And now we need to take care of that other Muton as well, but I don't want to use a grenade because that civilian is gonna die if we do that. So let's put... I think I'm gonna put Christoph on Overwatch, or maybe I'm gonna put him right over here. Because they don't see him yet, so... Let's try a shot at... I'm not gonna kill the Berserker in this turn, which might actually be bad, but... 31% on the Muton. If I hit, he dies, but... Yeah, that's a pretty high risk I'm taking there. But I'm not going to be able to kill the Berserker anyway, so let's try the Muton. It's a really low percentage shot, and of course he misses. Oh, I hope that didn't trigger the truck. Okay. Is he going for the... Yeah, he's damaged by the poison. Not that that's doing much. So he's damaged as well, and his aim is going to suffer from it. So if he's gonna try and shoot at Cedric, he's not gonna be good. The muton is no longer poisoned, but if he moves, he's gonna get poisoned again. And that's a Mac? Yeah, so a Mac that kills our first civilian. Caitlin Boyle, sorry girl. Sorry I couldn't save you. And now, what are you going to do? Yikes! Ooh, 6 damage. That was pretty bad. He got a hit in there. But now, the muton. Is he going for that civilian? He keeps... Okay. Wait, he didn't even fire. Okay, then. So if I put Benito over here... He should get a pretty nice shot on the... Wait, that's a flank shot, right? Yeah, okay. So that's a flank shot. Yeah, I'm gonna have to take that first because I don't wanna risk anything else happening here. That thing has gotta die. There we go. Okay. Don't trigger the truck. Please don't put the truck on fire. Okay. 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 We're getting there. So let's put Ulrich over here. Let's put. I think I'm gonna put Geralt over there because I know we're not gonna trigger anything from over there. If I put you here, you gonna save the civilian.
You're clear. Move out.
Yeah, okay, so that's our first civilian. Really, really good. And now we get a few shots at the Berserker, which is should be enough to kill him. Yeah. Hugh, now that you're here, by the way. Hugh, give me Hugh. There's Hugh. Do you have a line of sight on Cedric? Yeah, there we go. So I think the healing got improved because of the new gremlins. If I'm not mistaken, so that should heal a bit more than 4, or is it just 4? That was 5, yeah, okay. So he only lost 1 bar, if I'm not mistaken now. Yeah, okay. So that's something. If I'm want to do this right, I want to use Cedric to do the last shot. And yeah, so let's try with Ulrich first on the Berserker. 6 damage. Try not to destroy Benito's cover there, because, yeah, he's going to need that. So now he's enraged, so that means he's going to do more damage. He's going to go further than he was before. So I could suppress him. So penalize targets aim and shoot them if they move. But since my aim is so good on this guy, I'm just going to try and pelt him down with a few shots. So 6 more damage, and then we have Cedric's shot, and that should allow him to, well, not take an action because of the death from above. Here we go, 100%. That's gonna guarantee kill him. There we go, Berserker down.
You know that was good.
We don't even get a shot at that, so death from above, so it only takes 1 action, and now I can put him on Overwatch just in case there's something else. But only pistol Overwatch. That's interesting, actually. Maybe I should just reload you. We'll see what happens if I move Christoph next to the civilian. If that's a faceless, it shouldn't be, because she ran away. Because faceless don't run away from enemies, so that's kind of a way to see that. Okay, that's fine. And then that means that we should be able to put Hugh a bit further as well. And reload Cedric over here. I don't think he has... Oh, that was his autoloader. Okay, that was a bit of a waste. But never mind, let's put you on pistol Overwatch then. And then Christoph... I can actually put you a bit further to see if there's anything across this truck. Because you're still in concealment for now. Okay, so they're still moving to kill civilians probably, yeah. So that Mac has really gotta die because he's killing civilians from up there. Luckily, it's only one enemy that's killing civilians for now, which is actually pretty okay. So there we go. And now I'm gonna use the scanning ability to see what happens. So, scanning protocol. Good to do that early on in a turn, and especially if you don't have any enemies in sight. So that scans the... Yeah, there we go. So that one is a faceless. No biggie, because I don't think he gets an attack once he's scanned like that. He gets to move, I think. Or not. Okay. That's a bit more disconcerting because I don't really have a shot from over here. Okay, so let's put everybody a bit closer around the poison. Let's allow you to shoot at the faceless, so 0% critical. That's actually bad, but that's because I didn't take the perk that allows critical shots on squad side abilities. Let's see. There we go. 8 damage. That's really nice because that's the maximum he could do. Now he has 2 health left, but I don't really have a nice position to put Vryer. But I don't really need to put him in cover for now, so let's just put you a bit closer over there. And put you on Overwatch. If I put everybody on Overwatch, that should probably kill the man. And we can actually see... Ooh, that's actually interesting. So if I'm about to guess, that's a mech on the roof, we know that. Those two might actually be mutants, and that's probably another berserker, seeing the health bar. And that's probably just a Vibrio or a trooper, probably. So 6 enemies on the building, so there's the building we've been talking about. And the civilians are probably pretty close to that building, because I don't see any over here anymore, which is kind of sad. Because they can only kill 5 of those anymore. Let's put you on Overwatch anyway. Let's put everybody on Overwatch. Because I want to wait with... I don't want to be in the neighborhood of the poison anytime soon. I hope it disperses in the next turn. So there we go. So there's a mech. And that's a trooper, I think. That's a simple trooper. The red is kind of obscuring my view, but I think it's a trooper. I can actually shoot at it. Faceless, and then we have the advanced trooper and the advent mech with 2 armor. So that's fine, just gonna put you on Overwatch.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
And there we go, there goes the faceless. Is he going to go for the... No. No, you shouldn't kill civilians. You shouldn't kill civilians. Did he just heal himself? That is interesting. Yeah, okay. Yeah, that mech just happily starts killing civilians a bit more. So next turn, I should actually pull the attention of the mech and the trooper over there. Because I think the face is... Oh, hi! Hi! Well, that is an issue. So the berserker is leaving us, by the way. Bye-bye. And the 2 mutants are getting closer. They kind of look weird with the scanning effect on them. And that is an issue. That is a really big issue. Because that's all our Overwatch shots on those 2 mutants now. Oh shit. If that faceless moves, we're gonna lose a bit of health. So 2 missed shots by our machine guns. Oh god. Okay, that was 1 move. And that was a 2nd. So I don't think he gets an attack. I hope. Okay, yeah, okay. So Benito looks a bit of trouble because he's smelling the armpit smell of the faces over there. But he should be... Yeah, okay, so we're in control of Kistoff, so that's why all the eyes are there. What just exploded? Did the truck just explode? That was... Why? Did any civilians die from that? No. What was the damage they took then? Or that was just maybe... That was weird. Wait a second. Oh, the roof caved in over here. So both the mech and the trooper took damage because of the fall they took. That's interesting. Let's see. I think I should be able to take... out the... Oh, I don't have... I don't have lightning reflexes yet. So I should be careful here. I could try and get a bit closer with Kristoff, but he's in a really bad position. If that trooper spots him through the window, there we have a trooper and a mech at least extra on the board. So that's not really interesting. So, but it's good that the enemies come to us and not the other way around, because the berserker is still around here somewhere as well. Probably gonna try and kill a few civilians in the back there. So yeah, I'm gonna reload Geralt. There we go, and then fire at the faceless, who's right in front of him. He shouldn't be able to miss that. There we go. Goodbye, faceless.
Target neutralized.
So that allows Ulrich to get a bit closer, if I'm not mistaken. Although, are they close enough for a grenade, by the way? No, I don't think they are. No, not for a simple grenade, that is. So let's put that away for now. Ulrich, put yourself a bit closer. I'm gonna have to be careful that I don't trigger the trooper over there, but I think we're still far enough away. And otherwise, yeah, I take full responsibility for that if that happens, so no. Plasma grenade on top of these two lovely fellows. I don't think I can be able to reach that, but the rock will be destroyed. But yeah, two armor. I think I'm gonna kill the muton either way, but that's a really nice start for killing those two mutons. There we go. Oosh! Oh, two damage. So yeah, the armor still takes effect. That's not that bad. Because now we have a flank shot on both of them. Still don't know why mutons have that high of a defense. Because that's the reason why the shot percentages are so low. If I put Benito close, I'm probably going to trigger that trooper. Maybe I put you over here just to get a bit closer. That doesn't trigger anything. Although, wait a second. I can see him though. But I don't think I triggered those guys yet. Combat protocol. That's actually 4 damage right now, which is actually really good. I think it actually does more damage on the... Because combat protocol has higher damage on robotic enemies, and for some reason I can actually target the mech. Huh, that is interesting. Although I'm not really sure if I want to do that. But let's try this. I'm going to use combat protocol on the... Yeah, I want to do that. Can I do that? That's really, really weird. So that's 7 to 8 damage guaranteed on that mech. That actually works. Why does that even work? He's out of frame. Hi! For some reason that was only 4. Yeah, 4 and 3 damage. That's really good. Is he going to come over here now or... That didn't even trigger them, for some reason. There's something really funky going on over there. So 97, that's probably gonna kill the mech. Which is really good. Let's see how good we can do against those other guys that are still here. 67 on the muton, because I don't know why, because he doesn't really have any cover left. So we still have Hugh, Cedric, and Christophe's shot. I could use Christophe to take out the muton in the back there. Because Hugh doesn't really have a shot on the back one. And Cedric doesn't either, so... So yeah, let's try to kill this muton first. There we go, 6 damage. That wasn't guaranteed, but he did really nicely on that 67% shot. So that's another one down, and then we have Cedric. He still doesn't see. Why doesn't he see the muton over there? Oh, but I can't see the mech right now. That is interesting. What does the grapple actually do from over here? I could go on top of the burning truck. Yeah, that's not something I'm gonna do. Christophe has a shot at the muton, but it's pretty bad. I don't know why, but it's bad. If I go over here, I'm probably gonna be seen by the trooper, although that's not even really sure. It's not actually that good of a cover as well. This tree would actually be better, so let's put you over here.
No problem, boss.
That's gonna spot... Okay. Somebody saw me. What? Why are there three enemies all of a sudden? Trooper? Heavy lancer. Oh, that is an issue. So I could go for the shot at the muton right now. It's probably gonna kill him. It could actually not kill him as well. No, I'm gonna go for the mech. Just gonna kill the mech from over here. There we go. Goodbye, mech. Flopping down the roof. And then we shoot. That should have triggered that from above. Okay. So that means I can actually reload and then fire on the next turn. It should be good.
Ready to rock.
And I still have... it's an advanced loader, so that's 2 free reloads. Okay, then. Should I do anything else? I'm just going to use Pistol Overwatch. And then we have the... I'm actually going to check out the grenade. Because that Lancer is on the roof. No. Okay, never mind. I could try and take out the trooper over there, but he has 6 health left, and that's not going to even kill him. So let's just fire away at the Muton, hopefully killing him. And that only leaves the trooper and the... and the Berserker, of course. But I don't think the Berserker will reach us over here. There goes the Muton in the face. Critical. Those criticals on Christoph are really, really nicely. And loot.
This is it, right?
Loot. Is that batch triggered now? Because that wasn't really, really clear. Because it actually doesn't look like they're triggered. Because they're going to go for a civilian. Where's the Berserker? Oh shit, there's another batch of enemies in the back. Whoo! That is an issue. Especially since that Berserker is still out there. What is he gonna do? Oh shit, he's gonna stab me. Ow! 6 damage and disoriented. That is not that bad, because I can fix that. Except if the trooper is gonna fire at me and just kill me right now. Ooh, that was a bit of damage. Those guys really shooting to kill us. And there's the Berserker. Hi. Okay. We do have the capability to take everybody out, but I'm gonna have to be careful how we do that. First things first, I'm gonna heal... Kistoff. And I think that removes the disorientation. I'm not really sure, actually. Negative mental status effects are the other thingy. So, I'm just going to heal Christophe first. Let's see what happens then. I don't think that's going to remove the disorientation. There we go. That's a heal at least. Because I'm actually not sure what his shots are right now, even if he's disoriented. That still does 86% aim and a 90% critical, so I think you're gonna die. Yeah, that was exactly what I think that would happen. That disorientation did nothing for Christoph.
You know that was
he
good.
Didn't care for a bit, and that got him a promotion as well. Now Vryar, I think you're gonna have to focus your shots on the trooper over there. 80%, that's really good. So I'm gonna use that on the trooper. Yep, taking him out. 8 damage, oh yeah.
Did you see that one?
So now, what I actually want to do is... really stupid. But I would like to trigger those guys in the back. Because we can only... well, we can lose 3 more civilians. That's actually not that bad. But we do need to take out that Berserker in this turn. I think Benita's gonna have first shot on this. So 89% chance to hit that Berserker. And that actually missed for some reason. 89% miss. That was really interesting. Yeah, I don't know what that meant, but that was really, really bad. But that got them marked, so that means the aim of everybody else is boosted. Okay. I'm gonna have to be careful here. Because I don't have that many shots left, actually. I could go and pistol Overwatch and try to lure him out that way, because otherwise... ooh. I think I'm gonna have to heal Benito, because... Gremlin heal Benito, because otherwise, if he's gonna get hit by the Berserker, he's probably gonna die. So Gremlin heal Benito first. There we go. That is something at least. And then we're gonna fire with everybody else we got, although I could use a flashbang as well. Disorient all hostile targets in the affected area. Do we go with that over? Because I don't think we're gonna be able to kill him in this turn. 92% chance, we're gonna use that. There we go, 8 damage. That's gonna put him in enraged mode, probably. Okay, don't know. Did that put him in enraged? Because that wasn't really clear. I'm just gonna use the flashbang on him. Just use the flashbang on him, right? Right, like this. Yeah, like this. So that should hopefully cause him to miss his melee attack, because that's not guaranteed at all. There we go, disoriented. And then... I'm gonna put Cedric on Overwatch, and that's all we can do. So now we're gonna have to hope that the disorientation makes the Berserker do crazy things. And not hit Benito in the face with his giant... Wait. Yeah, okay, still happily killing civilians, that sectoid over there. Jeff Griffin. Is that Jeff Ramsey from Achievement Hunter then? That just died. There we go, 3 more damage. That's something at least. And he's gonna... Benito, duck. Duck. Did he? I think he just missed. I think he just plainly missed. Because they can't melee attack on that short range. So that was interesting. If I move you up to the tree, will the sectoid trigger? Because that's what I want to do, actually. I want to trigger the enemies over there so they don't kill any more civilians. So let's move everybody up as far as we can. So let's put Vrij over here and empty your mag cannon into that berserker. And that apparently missed. 86%. We have been missing 80%+ shots really a lot this time. There we go. Fire away. 90%. That was straight in the torso. And then I think we should be able to finish that off with a... Well, I'm not actually really sure, but let's try a lightning reflex shot. That can do 4 damage, so... Yep, there we go. That was really nicely done. And what I'm going to do next is I think I'm still going to try and bait those enemies in the back. Put Cedric on Overwatch, and there we go. If they come out... Yeah, okay, they got spotted. That's really good. Because that means they're probably not going to fire at the civilians. What's that? So that's a shield bearer and a sectoid. Is that it? Huh. They're actually really, really well covered over there. But we still have a grenade left. And these guys actually have grenades as well, so... If I can open up the building a bit more, we might actually get a shot for Cedric, although that's actually not really sure as well. Huh. I could just try and run and gun and kill at least one of those guys. That's not really what we want to do, right? We can't skulljack from this distance, but we can start rescuing a few civilians if I'm not mistaken. How far does that grenade go? Because I know with the advanced grenade launchers, we can actually boost that up pretty far. I think I'm going to do something really, really stupid right now. If I put you over there, so right in the open. They're not on Overwatch or anything, and I don't think they can see him from over there, yeah. If I put that inside... I can actually even hit the shield bearer. That's the shot I want to take, yeah. So that should take out the corner of the building and take the armor of the shield bearer. There we go. Our last grenade launcher grenade. Right through the window. There we go. And his armor is completely shredded. I wonder what shots that gives us. Benito doesn't see anything yet. But Cedric, do you... Ooh. He sees both of them. He sees both of them. That is really nice. So yeah, try to take out the shield bearer from over here. Oh, yes. That was nice. Impressed, yes? That was really, really nice. Yes, I'm actually really impressed. That was amazing. So that from above got triggered again. And now, how stupid can we go over here? Because if I just go... Oh, it's... The only piece of the wall that's still left is his cover. So if I boost you up to over here, I'm assuming there's no more enemies. Which might be a stupid move. But I'm gonna run and gun. Set him up, knock and put Kristoff over here. If there's an enemy left, is that a wall? I'm not really, I can't even see if that's a wall over there or not. I think it's blown open, because it's not marked as cover either. So I should be safe over here.
Good to go.
Do you see anything else? Okay, and you got the flank shield, so that should be 99 and 88%. Okay, here goes nothing. Oh, in the face, 13 critical. There we go, I think that's the end of it.
Burn it through ammo fast.
Oh shit. Yeah, of course. Yeah, of course. Should have known that that should happen. That would have happened, yeah. Okay. That is a bit of an issue. Where is that thing? I don't even see that on the map. I don't even see him. That is a big issue for, because Kristoff is gonna get eaten.
On the move.
Kristoff is gonna get eaten. We don't need to look at cover because, well, he just ignores cover anyway, so let's put you on Overwatch. Overwatch. And Overwatch. Is he gonna come into view of the other guys? Yeah, okay, he does. Please kill him. That's a miss. And that's also a miss. Okay, is he gonna kill Kristoff? Oh god. Hi. He's gonna swipe him in the face. Luckily, he has a lot of health. Was he far away enough? Okay. Who needs a promotion, by the way? Don't know who needs a promotion. Maybe they all don't see him, of course. So I'm just gonna try this. I'm not gonna take any risk. Hi. That didn't kill him. That was only 6 damage. Okay. Can we see through the wall here? If we put Ulrich over here, do you see the faceless? Oh, that's an issue. That is gonna be an issue, because he's in there. I'm gonna have to do the 1-2 punch. So let's put Benito over here. That's you. Never mind, you. Use your plasma grenade to blow open this side of the wall, opening up a line of sight to the faceless. There we go. That's not exactly the wall I wanted to take out, but never mind. Because now they still don't see anything. Oh, Benito does. Maybe I should take the shot from over here. Because if I risk it and put him over here, for example, and he doesn't see him anymore. No, let's put you over here. I think that's going to be, it's going to improve your hit chances. 83, come on. That was a hit, thank you very much. Okay, and that should be the end of it. Is it, please? No other faceless that's gonna pop up?
1-5, status confirmed. Whew. We're not picking up any additional contacts. The AO is clear.
Yes, indeed it is. Promotion status earned.
Confirmed. Mission accomplished.
That's gonna put him right at the end of the skill tree, I think. 13 enemies! But excellent, nonetheless. 8 turns for 13 enemies. So, average damage per attack 5 and 1.6 enemies killed per turn, because that was actually really, really nice. Cedric dealt most damage, Ulrich made most attacks, and Kristoff was under fire the most and moved the furthest, although I don't think he got the most damage on him. Yeah, not really sure about that. I think Benito got hit most. But this mission actually could have caused a bit of trouble, because most of the guys are now wounded, of course. So that means we're gonna have to go with the lesser guys. Look at that, 3 of those are, 13 days, 9 days, and 7 days. So we're gonna have to put an engineer in the med bay. But that's actually 4 promotions. That's actually really, really good. So Hugh, covering fire or threat assessment. Again, really, really hard. Overwatch shots can now be triggered by enemy action, not just movement. Or giving someone else an Overwatch shot. I could have done that in this mission a few times, actually, now that I think about it. But never actually did that. You know what? I'm gonna go for covering fire with Hugh. So he can use his Overwatch shots on actions of enemies as well as movement. Benito, let's see what the major skills are. So ever vigilant, if you spend all of your actions on moves, you're granted an automatic overwatch shot at the end of the turn. And then guardian, with every successful overwatch shot, there is a 50% chance that another shot will be taken. He has holo targeting, so the more shots, the better, because I think that actually stacks holo targeting. So yeah, overwatch shots that give him an extra shot if he hits it. His aim is pretty good, not that great, although 79 is actually not that great. Or automatic overwatch at the end of a double action might actually be handier. Although I like guardian, so let's go with guardian, never mind. There we go. Then Christophe, gravely wounded as well, but implacable or bladestorm. If you score one or more kills on your turn, you are granted a single bonus move. So that's really, really good, because that means if you kill someone after you run and gun, you get another move so you can back off again. And bladestorm, free sword attacks on any enemies that enter or attack from melee range. Could be handy, but I'm not building him out as a melee character, so I'm gonna use implacable on that one, because it's really, really handy for run and gun abilities at least. And then Cedric, and he got a hidden ability, that's actually really good. Deep cover, if you did not attack this turn, hunker down automatically. That's not actually really good, but nevertheless. And then, probably two of the most powerful skills in the game, for a sharpshooter at least. Killzone, take a reaction shot against any enemy that moves or attacks within a cone of fire. Which is actually really good if you're against a lot of enemies. Or Faceoff, fire once at every visible enemy with your pistol. That's really good, but I think we're building him out as a sniper, a really pure pure blood sniper, so I'm gonna go with Killzone. So take a reaction shot against any enemy that moves or attacks within a cone of fire. I do have to look out for an advanced magazine if I can, because that's of course gonna take a lot of ammo. And there we go, three promotions in the bag. And then an Illyrium core and a lot of corpses, of course, of all the enemies we killed. And then the Berserker, of course, that was new in this mission. This unusual specimen is clearly afflicted by some form of extreme muscular hypertrophy. Although how the species came to exist in this state will require a thorough examination. I suspect the research could lead to varying enhancements for our own troops, perhaps even some means of intensifying their own thirst for combat.
Hello, Commander.
Yes, so the resistance is really grateful, and our multi-supplies is increased by 29. Really, really good. And Cedric is shaken, sadly, because of the damage he took, because that was actually the first time he actually got any damage in his face. Let's see. So I'm going to remove one of the engineers over here. So Esmeralda Diaz is going to be taken out, and let's put her in the Advanced Warfare Center to increase the healing rate by 50%. By 100%, but doubling the healing rate. Let's go to the bridge and see if we can't go to the black market for a bit. We could get a soldier from the special forces thing on the map. Although the Avenger power thingy was also interesting. But we were building a relay, that was true. So let's build that first.
Setting course.
We're gonna continue building that first. The Avatar Project Timer is probably gonna start off again really, really soon. But let's see how that really furthers, because that's only, well, a little over a day. So there we go, a little cutscene to show us the relay. Doesn't look like much, a bit of duct tape all over the place. But now they can actually talk to everybody over here.
Welcome to the fight.
Yeah, welcome to the fight. And that's of course the larger relay. And that gives us a bit more supplies every month as well. So 105 supplies extra every month from... the Eastern Europe bonus has increased to 105. It's not 105 completely. So yeah, I think I'm going to go for the black market first. And then maybe that soldier. That might actually be interesting. Because we do actually need another... I don't think we're going to be buying. Because of course everything is double the price now because of the dark event. And we don't really have that much intel left. The engineer would be really interesting, though. 80 intel is a bit much, though. So yeah, intel costs, I think they're still doubled, right? I'm gonna have to check that in a minute, but first, let's sell some inventory. So they're very interested in the alien data cache, which I'm gonna sell anyway. And the trooper corpses, I'm gonna keep a few of those. Alloys, I really like alloys, so I'm gonna have to be careful with those. Data pads, I actually can give you one. It's not that bad. Anything else we have a lot of? Not really. So that's a nice bit of supplies, thank you very much. And then let's head out. I'm gonna check if that dark event is actually still active. Yeah. So Alien Cypher is still active, so that's gonna still double the intel costs we have. I'm gonna have to wait off with that, with buying a few new stuff things with the intel for now. What else could we do? With an extra engineer, we would be able to get two more contacts in. I'm gonna have to wait with that first, so I'm gonna have to scan for special forces. If
Avenger we're plotting new course.
If the Avatar Project timer starts off again, I'm probably gonna do the black side first, but if we could get another mission in between those two, that would be really nice. So Illyrium research is complete, so let's check that out. Having completed our analysis of the substance tentatively referred to as Illyrium 115, it's clear that this material is unlike any other naturally occurring element on Earth. Presumably the aliens extracted their undoubtedly extensive stores of Illyrium from another planet, but that is beyond my capacities to surmise. What I do know with certainty is that this element is incredibly reactive when exposed to high energy particle fields, providing a source of nearly limitless power that defies all known efficiency standards. Unfortunately, I see no means of replicating or synthesizing this substance with the resources available to us on Earth. The materials we recover from the aliens themselves will likely constitute the entirety of our available stockpile. The commander will have to be careful in choosing how to allocate these precious resources. So we now have a new facility available, the Illyrium Conduit. And then research for the plasma rifle and the powered armor. So now we can upgrade our armor and weapons even further if we want to. The faceless autopsy can now be completed instantly, so we're going to do that first.
I am at a loss for words to describe the difficulties we have had in attempting to handle this creature, affectionately known as the faceless, to our troops. The nebulous form of its physical structure, including a pliable semi-solid outer layer, seems to be slowly degrading now that the creature has expired. There is also a pungent odor that only seems to grow stronger as time passes.
So what we've learned from that is that a faceless smell.
Such a being. Is there another world out there filled with these shape-shifting creatures? Or are they merely another construct of alien genetic tampering?
Early reports from the Resistance referencing an alien creature said to be capable of shapeshifting were initially dismissed by local cell leaders who attributed the sightings to combat stress and malnutrition. It wasn't until our own forces engaged with the creature that we successfully confirmed its existence. Surprisingly enough, the description of the creature from those early reports was quite accurate. With a varying height of up to 3 meters, the specimen currently referred to as the Faceless has one of the most unusual internal structures I've ever encountered. Where one might expect to find a skeletal foundation, we instead see a series of malleable chitin-like structures providing various points for the expansion of several equally unusual fluid membranes. The membranes in question are responsible for the Faceless' extraordinary ability to mirror the form of a human in recirculating key cellular combinations via an elaborate internal structure. The faces is capable of forming solid shapes while also mirroring colors and textures without physical sampling. As of yet, we've only seen evidence of the faceless attempting to imitate humans but not other species or inanimate objects. Whether or not this is a limitation of their genetic makeup or an intentional manipulation of their abilities by the aliens, we cannot say at this time. So, the Mimic Beacon generates a holographic decoy that draws enemy attacks for one turn. It is deployed like a grenade, thrown to the site where the decoy will appear. And that is a lifesaver, actually, so that would be really, really interesting. So, new research. Let's see about this. Alien encryption. Plasma rifle and powered armor are of course really, really expensive to do, but we could go for the alien encryption by now. So that will boost up the main quest, if we want to call it like that.
I have a full report available.
I'm gonna build one if I'm able to. So let's go to engineering.
Just give the word and I'll get started, Commander.
Build items, and let's build one mimic beacon. So two faceless corpses and 75 supplies. There we go. Because that's gonna replace the flashbang. Well, I might actually take another flashbang with this as well, but
you must miss some of it. The food, the warm beds.
Honestly, none of that really bothers me. What I miss the most is my equipment.
I hadn't thought about that. Advent probably had a pretty nice lab set up for you.
There was certainly no shortage of resources on their side.
Don't worry. I'm sure the commander will find something nice for you.
Yes, of course, because we've been having, we've been giving him research projects ever since we got here. So let's see. Let's continue scanning for that soldier. And then the blue screen protocol is complete. That is really nice. So let's see. Assign new project, because the blue screen protocol, yeah, new item available, EMP grenades. EMP grenades wreak havoc on the delicate electronic systems and mechanical and robotic enemies, dealing considerable damage and potentially rendering them inoperable for a short period of time. Organic enemies are completely immune to these effects, however. And then the blue screen rounds, named for an inexplicable computing phenomenon common before the war, blue screen rounds wreak havoc on targeted electronic systems. So that's really, really interesting. We have another Illyrium core if we want to make something else. We could. The exosuit is really cool because we can add heavy weapons on that. But we could start with the further the advanced explosives as well. Maybe we should wait until the advanced explosives are complete and then check out what projects we can do after that. I'm actually wondering, can we actually make those blue screen rounds now?
Hello, Commander.
Not really sure about that. So yeah, blue screen rounds and EMP grenades. I think those are limited, so that's not something you can assign to all your troops, but it's always handy to have one of those at least. So let's make one EMP grenade. That might come in handy. So yeah, thank you very much. Let's head back to the bridge and continue scanning that soldier over there. Okay, and a resistance communication. So that's our monthly report.
I had high hopes for the resistance under your leadership, Commander, and you have outdone yourself.
So we've done a lot in this month. So we stopped one retaliation, completed one guerrilla ops, one council mission, we contacted one more region, installed a radio relay and investigated two rumors and reduced the Avatar project with one. So that's why they're so happy with us right now. So the monthly supplies is 280 supplies, which is really good. But now we're really close, of course, to that resistance informant, reducing the retaliation counter by 2 weeks. And then the Viper rounds could be harder to counter. But I think that also means that the dark event is gone right now. Yeah, so now we could technically go to the black mark to get some new fancy stuff. I'm going to prioritize the supplies here. So let's go to that first. We have not finished scanning. Yes, I want to go to the supply drop. Scan this bad boy. And we get supplies for every day we're here. So that's good. And now we have a supply rate. Okay, so that's going to be really, really good for our supply run. So let's check this out. Operation Mountain Gold, a raid to the Advent train.
Setting course for the Arctic territory.
Yes, we're gonna set course to that, because that's probably the last mission we're gonna do before the black side. I have been saying that a lot lately, but look at that, are they all back? They're all back. It's very difficult, but I think I'm gonna risk it and remove one of the grenadiers for another of the rangers. So let's put Jazz Gypsy here again. I'm gonna give him the beacon, the mimic beacon, because that's gonna be something that the guys that are closer will be able to use. There we go, mimic beacon. And then let's see, the grenades. Poison is really handy, but of course the simple grenades are good as well. I'm not really sure how many robotic enemies we're gonna come across. We're at a new month, so we actually might actually come across a few more robotic enemies. So just in case, let's take that EMP grenade with us, and then we're gonna have a normal grenade and an EMP grenade. And I'm actually going to give the poison grenade to Christophe then, because he's going to be able to use that as well. There we go, gas grenade. Easy peasy. And that's pretty much it. That's going to be the squad we're going to roll out with. So Hugh, Christophe, Benito, Ulrich, Jazz, and Cedric. So next up, supply rate, but that we're going to have to wait until the next episode, because I'm going to take a little break. So thank you guys, and obviously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really, really appreciate it if you did that. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video series. Goodbye!